There's something uncomfortable about being told what I should think about you, I've tried explaining to Mia. It fell on deaf ears. It's more uncomfortable having someone see you the wrong way, she replied with a shrug. And perhaps she's right. Monday arrives with such a normalising force that I almost burst into tears on the train to Ellingsrud. The autumn darkness unites us passengers in a fellowship that I never feel on bright summer mornings. A sociable silence, perhaps a sense of mutual sympathy, an acknowledgement that we are among those who have been roused from their slumber at 6 o'clock in the morning to make it to work on time, in spite of the bleak November darkness and biting cold, no sign of snow. I am part of this fellowship, my shoulders pulled up to my ears as I blow into my hands, but there's no month that I like more. No events, no annual celebrations, no emergencies, just the uninterrupted and tranquil darkness that eats away at the days in ever greater chunks. The 40-minute commute to work and back has become the highlight of my day, a comfortable intermediate moment when I'm able to escape demanding patients and equally demanding relatives. As I step off the train, I try to call Mum for the third time, but get no reply. And for the first time since Friday, I allow myself my usual worry for her, a feeling that is of such a constant and fixed size within me that it could be an aching body part in its own right, occasionally tamed, but ever present. I spend a disproportionately long time seeing my first patients, as usual, spend far too much time with Ingrid. She's 90 years old, and always carries a bag of boiled sweets, which she hands out to patients in the waiting room and staff on the front desk. She always strokes my cheek before she leaves, like some sort of universal grandmother figure.